As we all know, watching the NBA is absolutely incredible, but imagine diving even deeper into the lives of some of basketball's biggest names. Now you can with this new memoir written by the NBA's most coveted skills trainer, and he just happens to be a Cranston native, Rob McClanaghan. It is called Network, Training the NBA's Best and Finding the Keys to Greatness. Good morning, Rob.
Yeah, how you doing?
Great to have you here.
Thanks for having me.
Let's talk about your journey, you know, being from Cranston, now rising through the ranks and training some of the biggest names. You know, I'm a massive basketball fan. You know, the forward on this book written by Steph Curry, one of the greatest players in the league today, but there are so many other names you've worked with. How did you make this journey? Where did it all begin?
A while back, I played at Henrikin, a local guy, and then played at Syracuse. And then I went back, I taught at Henrikin, on the side, the summers off, obviously, and I was a coach there. And during the summers, I started training a bunch of guys. My first ever two pro players were Ryan Gomes and Ruben Garces.
So local guys from the Friars.
Local guys. And then started interning at IMG Academy, got into ABCD camp with Sonny Vaccaro, and that's where I met Derrick Rose and Kevin Love. And from there, Kevin brought in his roommate, this guy named Russell Westbrook.
He's pretty good, too.
So, I definitely got a little lucky with those three in the beginning, and from there, it kind of just took off.
As this is all starting to take place, as you are rising, you know, cultivating this career, do you ever have to just step back and think, do you ever think about where you came from? Does it seem possible?
Yeah, definitely. I never thought this would be a career.
Right.
I just thought, kind of do it on the side, but, To be from Cranston and work with some of the best players in the world, it's definitely been a heck of a ride. But sometimes I got to pinch myself. But these guys are just normal human beings, so it's a weird thing for me because they are just normal guys.
And they all have one thing in common, and that is obviously they love competing. They want to be the best at what they do, but they all have to have that drive. And it doesn't matter how much talent you have; you have to be willing to put in the work. Yep. You've got to grind it out, especially the NBA, 82 games plus the playoffs for a lot of these guys. Do you find they all share that common link that hey, they have that drive, they want to get better, they're committed to it?
Yeah, definitely. It's a full-time job. It's 24 hours a day. It's not just the way you train with me, but it's the yoga, it's the eating, it's the sleeping. So you have to really live like a pro, and every guy in there has been a true pro, and that's why they're great.
Yeah, let's talk about the book and what people can expect in it and really what you hope people will take away from it.
Yeah, the first two chapters are kind of how I built my business, but the next, I would say, 9 to 10 chapters are really just every player interviewed for it. You're from Kevin Durant to Kevin Love to Steph to D-Rose to Russell, and it's just kind of behind the scenes stories of what makes them great and how I network to really get to where I'm at.
Mm-hmm. And there'll be a signing this weekend, correct?
The signing, Garden City, Barrington Books, 2 o'clock this Saturday, October 5th. So hopefully people come out and support.
Yeah, they can ask you questions, meet you, and learn more about you.
Yep.
Basketball is by far my favorite sport. Yep. I love the game so much. I mean, I'm no stranger to the court. And by no stranger, I mean I carry the Gatorade to the bench.
I do
love the game. But for you, how did you fall in love with the game? Because it really is the best, I think.
Honestly, my whole life I've had court-size season tickets to the Friars. So I kind of grew up in the Big East, was the Big East. UConn, Syracuse,
yes,
and Providence, and old school, Rick Pitino. So kind of just fell in love with it then and just kept going. I grew up in the 80s and 90s when it was Magic and Larry and Michael. So that was my first love.
And you truly are an inspiration. And people watching this, they pick up the book, they come meet you. This may inspire them to realize, hey, I can work within the field and make a career of it.
Yeah, I mean, that's the goal. Just, if you network the heck out of yourself and you're persistent, you can kind of, do whatever you want.
If you ever need Gatorade or towels, I'm your man.
I got it.
Rob,
appreciate it.
Pleasure to have you here. Best of luck with the book.
Thank you.
I'll wait for my call to write the foreword on the second edition. You never know. Make sure you guys don't miss Rob's book signing this Saturday, October 5th, 2:30 at Barrington Books.